between America and Saudi Arabia escalating this week, with the White House accusing the Saudis of, quote, coercing its allies to cut oil production and side with Russia. CNN's Natasha Bertrand reports now on the pressure mounting in Congress for the Biden administration to act and the options the president is now considering.
Tensions between the U.S. and Saudi Arabia escalating sharply this week, with U.S. officials accusing the Saudis of strong-arming OPEC into cutting oil production and helping Russia maintain its war machine in Ukraine.
The Saudis have conveyed to us, both privately as well as publicly, their intention to reduce oil production, which they knew would increase Russian revenues and potentially blunt the effectiveness of sanctions. We made clear that that would be the wrong direction.
The OPEC Plus decision to cut oil production by as much as 2 million barrels per day has rattled the White House, which now says it is reevaluating its relationship with the Saudis, one of the U.S.'s most important Middle East allies, just months after President Biden traveled to Jeddah in an effort to mend an already faltering relationship.
I am in the process, when the House and Senate gets back, there's going to be some consequences for what they've done with Russia.
Multiple sources also telling CNN that other OPEC Plus members, including the United Arab Emirates and Iraq, opposed the Saudi-led decision. Those countries have now indicated to the U.S. that they may not move forward with the kind of huge cuts that Saudi Arabia wants, one of the sources said. The Saudis have pushed back against the Biden administration, releasing a rare written statement accusing the U.S. of trying to distort the facts and insisting the decision was based purely on economic considerations.
Saudi Arabia is not siding with Russia. Saudi Arabia is taking the side of trying to ensure the stability of the oil markets.
As the Biden administration considers how to punish Saudi Arabia, a senior official tells CNN they've been purposefully vague to keep the Saudis guessing. But one option lawmakers are considering is to ban future weapon sales to the country once Congress is back in session.
I think it's unlikely that we will support any additional arms sales to the Saudis. This was a punch in the gut.
There are currently no imminent weapon sales to Saudi Arabia in the pipeline, though, and experts are skeptical that the relationship will fundamentally change.
Because of Saudi Arabia's activities in the war in Yemen and the civilian casualties they caused, followed by the murder of Jamal Khashoggi, Congress has become more and more critical and controlling of U.S. foreign military sales to Saudi Arabia. There's very little coercion left that the U.S. can do in trying to control military sales to Saudi Arabia.
Now, a U.S. official told CNN that the OPEC announcement was, quote, a lot of theater, and is ultimately unlikely to take the full 2 million barrels of oil per day off the market. But the U.S. is looking to OPEC's next meeting in November to see whether the cartel stays on this path.